Hey, it's Jason. I'm going to put together three videos for you which cover logic functions. Logic functions deal with true and false. In this first video, I'm going to talk about the AND function, which lets you test lots of different things, and if all of those things are true, you can do something. And also the OR function, which allows you to test lots of things, but this time if any of them are true, you can do something. So it's all explained in this video. Enjoy. We have a small table here that we're going to use for demonstration. It's all about some tradespeople. So over here we have their name, the car they drive, their trade, where they're based, their hourly rate, and their jobs. I'm going to demonstrate two logical functions in this video, the AND and the OR functions. Now they're both logical functions and they both work on a true and false basis. So first of all, the AND function allows us to test two or more conditions. And if all of those things we're testing are true, the answer is true. The OR is very similar. It allows us to test two or more things, but this time, if any of those things are true, the answer is true. Now, both of these use what's called logicals, and a logical has three parts to it. So there's the cell reference that we're trying to check for, what we're checking for, and the value we're checking for. An example might be, let's say we're checking to see if a particular person is a plasterer. You can say, first of all, the cell reference is whatever cell we're checking, equals to, and then the part three is the plasterer. Or let's say we're checking if their hourly rate is below 50 an hour. So again, you check the cell reference, this time less than or less than or equal to, and then 50 for the value. So that's the idea. There's always got to be the three parts to the logical. So bear that in mind as I go through these examples. Here's the data again. Let's make up a scenario here. So let's say we want to pick out any plasterers who drive a Holden. Okay, so we're checking the trade for plasterer and the car for Holden. Now, as we go through, because we're going to be creating one formula and copying it down, it's important to check the data on the same row as the formula, otherwise it won't make sense when we copy it down. So let's just write it up here, what we're checking for. The way we write the function is a little bit counterintuitive the first time you do it, because in English we structure it a certain way, but in Excel, AND is the function name, so we have to start with that. So we start with equals AND. Open the brackets. You can see here it's asking for these things called logicals. Now, just to make things easier and a bit clearer, I'm going to click FX, which gives us the box so you can quite clearly see what I'm doing as I do it. So here's your logical one, logical two. And once you do a logical two, logical three comes into play and so on. So you can actually do as many conditions as you like. Now, logical one, we're checking the trade. So we click on the trade cell for this row. We then say equals, and then the value is plasterer. Now, notice how I put plasterer in quotes there because it's text. Tab down. Now, the second logical I'm going to be checking for is, do they drive a Holden? So again, I click on the car cell for the same row and say, is that equal to, and then again in quotes, Holden. That's it for this one. So we click OK. And you can see the first one's false because both bits are not true. Yes, they drive a Holden, but they're not a plasterer. As I copy this down, you should see a combination of true and false. So the ones that are showing true, you can see Holden and plasterer there. And Holden and plasterer there. So both bits are true. Let's do another example. So let's say we're trying to pick out anybody in Queensland who charges less than 60 an hour. So the way we write the function again is equals AND, open brackets. We're checking the trade to say is it equal to, and then in quotes again because it's text, Queensland, comma. Now because I'm just using the screen tip here and building the function myself, I have to put that comma in. Of course, when you click the FX here, and you put stuff in the separate boxes, it adds those commas for you. So my second logical is, do they charge less than 60 an hour? So I check the hourly rate. I say less than 60. Notice there's no quotes this time because 60 is numeric. Close the brackets and enter. So again, if I copy this down, you'll see a combination of true and false. So the ones that are showing true are where they're Queensland and they charge less than 60. Where it says false, they're either not in Queensland or they charge 60 or more. So that's the idea of the AND function. Let's do one example of an OR function. So let's say we're trying to check if they are a brickie or a roofer. So this time I say equals OR, open the brackets. The logical this time is click the trade cell. Is that equal to, open the quotes, brickie, comma, the same cell again, equals roofer. Two conditions. Each logical has those three parts to it. If either one of those is true, the answer is true. So again, if I copy that down, you'll see a combination of true and false. true where they're a brickie or a roofer. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to combine and or into the same formula, so you can actually check a combination of different things all in one hit. I'll put the links for that on this page. Check that out if you're interested. See you for the next one.